What's up, guys? Welcome to Superwise. I'm John, and we got a couple of interesting movie news stories to talk about today, but first, let's start off with WandaVision. Paul Bettany recently did an interview with Total Film and revealed that WandaVision will be super ambitious, have some of the biggest set pieces the Marvel Cinematic Universe has ever seen, and even have more VFX shots than they had in Avengers Endgame. Which, I mean, is crazy if you think about it. Avengers Endgame is the biggest movie of all time, and it had so much CGI. It was CGI central. So the fact that WandaVision will have even more VFX shots than Endgame, wow, that's intense. And I mean, it makes sense because WandaVision is going to be setting up Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness and Spider-Man 3, and it's going to set up the whole multiverse situation, so it makes sense that there are going to be a lot of CGI and VFX shots. Also, Elizabeth Olsen dodged a question on Jimmy Kimmel about if the House of M storyline from the comics will be incorporated into the Disney Plus WandaVision show. She didn't answer it, and come on, if you've read the comics, it seems like the House of M will be incorporated into this show, setting up Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. I won't spoil anything, but yeah, I think it's very likely we'll get the House of M storyline into the MCU. Not a lot of you may know this, but Sylvester Stallone is starring in another superhero movie in the lead. It's a movie called Samaritan, directed by Julius Avery, and releasing on June 4th, 2021. And this is our first official image from this movie. And there's not a lot of information on it. There's a couple of plot details. Like, this movie is essentially Logan, where Sylvester Stallone is a retired superhero who is presumed dead, but he's coming out of the shadows to help a child who is looking for a father figure. That's basically the synopsis for this film. And hey, I'll basically watch anything with Sylvester Stallone. He's one of my favorite actors. He's one of the most iconic actors in all of Hollywood. Rocky, Rambo, of course. And he's already played two superheroes before, Judge Dredd, and Demolition Man, and now he's playing this third superhero role. Not to mention that he's been in both Marvel and DC movies. Man, Sylvester Stallone is getting it all. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this movie. And director Julius Avery said that Sylvester Stallone is doing heavy action scenes in a really inventive way, so I mean, yeah, excited. And finally, ever since that ending to Avengers Endgame, when Thor joined the Guardians of the Galaxy, we all assumed that the Guardians of the Galaxy would show up in Thor 4 Love and Thunder. And when Chris Pratt was confirmed by the Hollywood Reporter to return as Star-Lord for Thor Love and Thunder, we were like, okay, are there going to be any other Guardians of the Galaxy members in there? Well, new pictures from the Daily Mail website reveal that the whole freaking Guardians team will be in Thor Love and Thunder. Love and Thunder is currently filming in Australia, and here you can see Chris Pratt, Star-Lord himself, getting ready to film his scenes for Thor 4. Karen Gillan, who plays Nebula, is going to be in Thor Love and Thunder as well, and is also in Australia ready to film her scenes. Dave Bautista, who plays Drax, is ready to shoot his scenes in Australia. In addition to the Guardians, as expected, Tessa Thompson is reprising her role as Valkyrie and is ready to shoot her scenes in Australia. But that was the video. I personally am very much looking forward to Love and Thunder. I absolutely adore Thor Ragnarok. It's my second favorite MCU movie of all time. I love how Taika Waititi handled the Thor character. And I love the direction Taika took for this series, making it more comedic, more fun. And now Taika's back. He's teasing that Love and Thunder is going to be crazier and wackier than Ragnarok. You got the Guardians back, and you got Christian Bale as the main villain, Gore the God Butcher. Lots of things to look forward to here. So anyway, feel free to leave a comment down below and tell me what you think about all this Thor 4 news. Are you excited for the movie? Are you not? Tell me what you think about the Sylvester Stallone Samaritan movie. Did you know about it up until this video? Did you not? I'd love to read your comments. that will be all for me. Please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subbed already, please come on over. I'd love to have you. That will be all for me, and remember my catchphrase, guys. Stay super wise.